Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. It's Jess. It's been a while since I uploaded, so I thought I would come back. I really missed you guys, and today we're going to be reviewing the Nintendo Switch. It's in its case right now, but I will take it out to show you guys the Switch. But I'm very excited. I got my Nintendo Switch for Christmas, and I got the Lite because it's so much more cheaper, and also I just like the portability aspect of it. So that is why I got the Switch Lite. Also, I didn't pay for it, so I didn't want my aunt spending too much money on me. But yeah, don't forget to like this video if you really truly enjoy it, and subscribe for some more Disney content. Let me take her out of the case. This case also is phenomenal. It's heavy duty, it's very protective. Here we have my Switch. I got the coral color because the coral is so pretty and I just love it. Here is the Nintendo Switch. I do have a case on and a screen protector, and you can see me. Hi there. But this is the Nintendo Switch. It's so light and so portable. I love the handheld aspect of it. It makes me feel like a gamer. Like I really am a gamer, to be honest. And I'm definitely taking it on my trip to Vancouver and Calgary. I'm very excited for that. I'm not gonna vlog that. Okay, now back to the Switch. So this Switch, the screen is smaller than my phone, but it's still definitely great if you want the portability aspect of it and you just want some way to game while you're traveling or whenever. So it's really good, even though it's not the same experience as a regular Switch and the Switch OLED, but it's still a great experience. You still get that gaming aspect. It's still really great. So I wanted to talk about a few things with the Nintendo Switch. So first off, it's portable. Now I carry this case, which came with a bunch of different accessories, which I'm very excited about. As I said before, this console is perfect for traveling, and that's what I really like about it. The only thing I will say is you have to have Wi-Fi to play certain games. I don't know if it's all games, but definitely with Fortnite, when I was trying to play it at my friend's house and I didn't have the Wi-Fi, I couldn't play Fortnite. So I don't know if it's all games that have that, but I think majority of them you need Wi-Fi. I guess it's not the greatest if you're going on the plane, although now airplanes have Wi-Fi, so I think it should be fine. I'm definitely taking this with me either way, whether I could play it on the plane or not. But it's very portable and very easy to travel with, and I'm really happy about that. Next, I wanted to talk about the controls. So the controls are the same as the regular Switch and the Switch OLED, but they're obviously smaller and you're working with a smaller surface. But I heard that a lot of people say that the joysticks, there's like problems with it. I haven't had any problems with it, only once where this controller was too stiff, and it wasn't the greatest experience in my opinion, but it worked after that, so everything's good. I haven't had any problems with the Joy-Cons except for the stiffness of the control, but I haven't had that problem ever since, so I think it should be okay. I think you just have to be careful with it. Like, it's obviously expensive, and with anything expensive you have to be careful with it. So I would say get it if you're worried about the controls breaking or something like that. Don't worry about that, because I've had mine for a while and I haven't had any issues. Another thing I really wanted to talk about is it worth the hype, and is it worth it rather than the regular Switch and the Switch OLED? I gotta say this, it depends on your personal preference. So I obviously want it for the portability aspect, but you may want a Switch that can go on a bigger screen, and that you would need this regular Switch or the Switch OLED. So I personally didn't care about that, so I got the Switch Lite. It honestly just depends on what you want it for. If you want ultimate gaming experience, I would go with the Switch OLED. And then if you want a bigger monitor but you want to save some money, I would say go with the regular Switch or the Animal Crossing Switch. And then yeah, if you want it just to play handheld play, then just go with the Switch Lite. It really just depends on what you want your experience to be like. I think I might upgrade to a Switch OLED in the near future. Not now, but definitely when I'm out of my house and I find an apartment, I'm definitely getting the Switch OLED because I would like to play on a bigger monitor. But for now, handheld play is fine. And also, I just love this. This is such a pretty color. Like, you cannot tell me it's not. It's so pretty. And the case, I love that it matches. Anyways, I keep getting sidetracked, but yeah, that's all I pretty much have to say about the Switch. I'm gonna be talking about some games that I have. So I don't have a lot of games. I have 4 games, 2 digital, 2 physical versions. So I have this case right here for the 2 physical versions. And I have Animal Crossing in the Switch already. And I have Mario Kart in this little case. And then my digital games are the Kirby game and I don't know what it's called. And then Fortnite. So I really like all those games. From my experience, using the Switch to play these games is actually really nice. It's a really nice experience. Even though it's a Switch Lite, it's still a very nice experience. And I haven't had any issues playing with the games. I actually really enjoy playing Animal Crossing during my downtime. It's really relaxing and I would highly recommend it. If you want something a little more intense and a little more engaging, I would go with Mario Kart because you guys know Mario Kart is amazing and I missed it a lot because I used to have a Wii and I used to play on there but it broke. So I'm so glad I have Mario Kart because now I can play multiplayer. Like I play multiplayer with Fortnite. It's actually been a great experience. Like I haven't had any complaints about that at all. And I played Fortnite with multiplayer. I played with my friend Anthony and we play a lot, so it's a great experience. Obviously there's a big difference between the regular Switch and the Switch Lite in terms of graphics, but it's okay. I'm okay with the graphics of this. So again, it depends on your personal preference, but I would say gaming is a great experience overall and I would highly recommend getting the Switch Lite if you want handheld play and you want to save a couple hundred bucks. So yeah, that is all that I have for this review. I know this was kind of jumbled and like really random and I know I haven't been on the internet in a while, but definitely go follow my TikTok and my Instagram because I'm very active on there and I will be back on YouTube again, so I'm very excited. Thank you guys for watching and cue outro. That is the end of today's video. I hope you guys enjoy. Let me know in the comments below what videos you want to see from me and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.